This is a University of Sheffield Health Service screencast.
This is a screencast on the common cold. Have you got a cold, or have you just had one? Colds can affect people throughout the year, not just in winter. There are many different types of viruses that can cause a cold. These can be found in the nose, mouth, and eyes of a person who has caught a cold. They can also travel in air droplets if sneezed or coughed out and can settle on non-living objects. Colds can affect the ears, nose, throat, sinuses and voice box. When you have a cold, you can expect to have some or all of the following features. Fever, minor headaches, sinus pains over your cheeks and above your eyebrows, nasal congestion, coughing green yellow sputum, earache, sore throat and a hoarse voice. Features that would be unusual for a cold would be if they were rapidly worsening with time, if the fever or headache was not calming down with simple measures, if the cough produces mucus with blood in it, or if you're unable to tolerate food or you're vomiting. Look out for any of the signs of meningitis. Please enable the annotations function to see the Meningitis Trust web address for information. If you're worried you have the flu, then please ring your GP first rather than attending the health service. So when should you expect to feel better? Usually there is no exact time for recovery from a cold. People start to feel unwell 2 to 3 days after catching the cold, but most people feel better within 1 week. The features can last up to 14 days before things start to improve. So how can you treat your cold? Your body's infection-fighting system or immune system will eventually clear the infection itself. The only thing you can do in the meantime is to keep comfortable whilst this is happening. You can try simple things like resting, drinking fluids, eating what food you can manage, and taking paracetamol and or ibuprofen regularly for the pain and fever. A pharmacist can tell you if you're safe to use these medicines before you buy them. Cough and cold remedies are no longer available for young children, so you should seek the advice of a pharmacist on what is safe to give your child. So what about antibiotics for a cold? We are often asked if antibiotics help in this situation. Antibiotics can't kill viruses, so the answer is no. Studies show that the vast majority of people who were given antibiotics for a cold would have improved with time anyway. The disadvantages of taking antibiotics are that they can give allergic reactions, have side effects such as stomach upset, and can interfere with other tablets such as the contraceptive pill. This is why doctors prefer not to give antibiotics for colds. For advice on missed time due to illness, please see the annotation for the relevant university website that will give you further advice. If you feel you're going to miss a university assessment or examination due to illness, please try to contact the health service beforehand in case any medical proof is required. People often wonder why they catch so many colds. It's usually the case that each time you may be catching a different type of cold virus that your immune system hasn't previously met. Children tend to catch more colds than adults. This is because adults have built up an immunity against some of the viruses that cause colds. On average, adults have between 2 and 4 colds a year, whilst children may have as many as 8 or 10. If you have more frequent or more severe infections, see your GP. A healthy lifestyle, including exercise and a balanced, nutritious diet, will help your immune system to fight infections. Smokers are prone to chest problems throughout the year. Click on the button to look at our screencast if you're interested in quitting. You should ensure that you're up to date with your vaccinations against more serious illnesses, such as mumps, measles, rubella, and meningitis. Please allow the annotations function to see where you can get further information. Remember that you can catch up on all the latest UHS news on our Twitter page. This is the end of our screencast on the common cold.